Hi, and welcome to episode 13 of the 21st Century Pharmacist Show. As always, I want to thank all of you out there who share and like and just say so many good things and send us so many great questions. We really appreciate it, and we really hope you'll continue to do so and subscribe to our YouTube channel. The last four series, or the last four shows, was a four-part series about the truth about fat. So please go back and watch that if you missed it. And so we talked about things that we wanted to avoid, like genetically modified or GMOs, genetically modified organisms or GMO foods. We talked about avoiding things that were, or we feel like you should avoid things that are sprayed with these glyphosates and all these other chemicals that just aren't natural to be on our food or in our bodies. And we talked about, why we want to do that, why we want to avoid these so-called healthy vegetable oils and these canola oils and corn oils and soybean oils. So we want to talk about this week how we kind of put the highest quality ingredients in our body on a daily basis. Where do we find them? How do we get them? Where do we source them? And just, we want this to be really practical. That's the reason that the second class that I teach in my OptiLife Wellness Summit is preparation, because we got to make this simple, we got to make this easy, and we got to make this something you can do for life. This is about making changes for the rest of your life that will change your health and your quality of life and the quality of life of your family and your children forever. So that's what we want to think about. So a lot of the questions that I get is, I just can't find grass-fed, grass-finished beef. I don't even know where to start in my area. Well, certainly here we use Windy Hill Farms. Charles and Dana actually deliver here to the pharmacy in Kings Mountain, and they have totally grass-fed, grass-finished beef. No hormones, no antibiotics are ever given to their cows. And so that's the things that we're looking for. So one of the things that I talk about and teach in my class is you need to find a local farmer's market, or at least some local farmers. And you need to ask them what they do, because there's a lot of things that can be deceiving if you're not careful and don't know to ask the right questions. So one of the easy things you can do is go right up to somebody who farms, or somebody who's at the farmer's market who's a farmer, and just ask them what they do. What do you feed your animals? Do you give them hormones? Do you give them antibiotics? And if they say grass-fed, that's awesome. You ask, are they grass-finished? Which means that the cow or the cow ate grass from the day it was born until the day that it went to be processed. So we want to make sure, because when we have some things that say grass-fed, that can mean that it was grass-fed some, and then it was fed grain some. And those, again, are typically going to be the corn and the soy and the canola and all the things in the feed that have the genetically modified ingredients that have the herbicides and pesticides that we're trying to avoid. So just ask the right questions. Is it grass-fed, grass-finished when it comes to beef? When it comes to chicken, is it pastured? Is it free-range? And I don't mean it's in a cage with a door open, which is what you'll often see how they label it in the grocery stores. But ask the farmer, are the chickens out in the field? Are they eating bugs? Are they eating grass? Are they eating leaves? Are they eating the things that chickens would naturally eat? And are they given hormones? Are they given antibiotics? And if you do have to supplement their feed, and you do sometimes with chickens, are you using a non-genetically modified feed? Those are the questions that you want to ask when it comes to chicken. And then pork is not something we recommend that people eat a lot of in our program, but pork can have good fat in it, which is one of the five pillars of our program is eating high quality fats. That's a God-given quality foods. The first thing's high quality fats. So with pigs, the same thing. We want pigs that are free to roam around, free to play in the mud, and they're eating the things that pigs would naturally eat. And again, they're not being fed genetically modified ingredients and not being fed hormones and antibiotics. So we can certainly make better choices by doing that. When it comes to fish, we want to make sure that we're eating wild caught fish, not fish that is farm raised, not fish that is fed these GMO products again, these feeds again that contain these GMOs and these herbicides and pesticides, and often given hormones or antibiotics, certainly at least. So we want wild-caught fish. We want free-range chickens and pigs and cows that have eaten what they would naturally eat, what God intended them to eat, and not fed these genetically modified pesticide, herbicide-laden feeds and foods. And when it comes to vegetables and those things, we want to do the same thing. We want to find vegetables that are not genetically modified. We want to find vegetables that are not sprayed with this glyphosates and all these other chemicals, this 2,4-D. We want to avoid those. So again, ask the farmers. You can look them in the eye typically at the farmer's market, and you can ask them. So you can Google, you can find, farmer's markets are making a big comeback in my area certainly, and in most places I go teach this. There's more and more farmers markets coming along because more and more people are getting savvy to the idea that, hey, maybe these foods aren't really healthy for me, and maybe some of the things that we're eating and the things that we're eating have been fed contain ingredients that I really don't want to put in my body and I don't want to put in my family's bodies. So make it simple. Find you a farmer's market. They're usually there 1 or 2 days a week, typically usually Saturdays, and some of them around here again on Tuesdays or Wednesdays. So you have options to go and get these things. And what you'll find is when you get fresh veggies and things from farmers markets, they'll last so much longer and they'll taste so much better and they'll contain so much more nutrition, and you'll just feel better and you'll be healthier for it. The thing that I probably missed that I should have talked about was eggs. We recommend eating a lot of eggs because we think they're super healthy. We think they contain a lot of good fat. We think they contain a lot of good protein. Again, we want free-range pastured eggs with no hormones, no antibiotics, no GMO feed, none of those things. And you'll see and you'll taste the difference. As soon as you crack those eggs, you'll know the difference. So have fun with food. We teach people this is not a diet. We're eating a lot of good, great-tasting food, and we're using real grass-fed butter on it, and we're using healthy fats, and we're eating avocados with it. And I mean, it's a lot of fun to eat this way, and the beauty of it is you can not only eat this way, but it can be simple, it can be super healthy, and typically when you can go straight to the farmer, straight to the source, you can get it for less money than you could get if you were trying to go to the store and find the same thing, because we're really cutting out the middleman. So just don't overcomplicate it, but do your research, do your homework wherever you are, and make sure you find the best sources to get the cleanest food, because the way to optimal health, wellness, and fitness starts with what we eat and what we put in our body. So I hope you enjoyed this. Please share and like, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and I'll see you next time. The most important things we need to know are not just total LDL, but the particle sizes of the LDL, because the bigger the particle sizes, the less likely they are to create havoc in my arteries and in my heart and create those issues.